This is Jake Shooker with Reliable Home Security, and today we're going to learn how to enable Z-Wave on your 2GB Go control panel, and this will allow you to learn in your home automation devices such as thermostats, lighting, and electronic door locks. So, to enable the Z-Wave on the 2GB Go control panel, you'll notice currently the Home Services button when you select it, and then select Z-Wave. It'll tell you that the feature is currently disabled. So we need to go into programming and not only enable the Z-Wave feature, but also enable the different home automation devices we would like to learn in. So to do that, we want to go ahead and hit Security, want to hit Menu, and then Toolbox. You want to go ahead and enter in your installer code, which is different from the master code. So enter in your installer code, and ours currently is 1561, and that is the default out of the box for the 2GB panel. Once you're in programming, you want to hit the left arrow and scroll over and select Installer Toolbox. And then we want to go to System Configuration. And this is where the programming for the entire panel lives. So we need to go to the programming fields to turn on Z-Wave as well as turn on the home automation devices we're interested in learning in. So to do that, we want to hit Go To 7979, and as you can see, the Z-Wave features are currently disabled but visible. So we want to scroll over and change it to number 3, enabled on panel, rules disabled, remote access enabled. If you're using alarm.com to control your interactive features, which most of you will be, to control the features from your phone or computer, this is the setting you'll want to have it in, because this will give you the ability to remotely access your lighting and thermostat or door lock features. So once we've selected number 3, enabled on panel, rules disabled, remote access enabled, we now have the Z-Wave feature on and want to go and turn on the different home automation devices one by one. So we'll hit Go To 80. As you can see, Z-Wave switches. So these will be for light switches, lamp, or appliance modules. It's currently disabled, so we just hit the right arrow and scroll over and turn it to enabled to turn it on. And that's all you have to do. Then we'll hit Go To 81. And this is for the thermostats, to enable thermostats. So again, hit the right scroll arrow to enable it and turn it on. And that's all you need to do there. And then we'll hit Go To, if you're interested in doing locks as well, 82. And change that to enabled as well by hitting that right scroll arrow once again. These are the 3 main Z-Wave features the 2GB supports. There are hundreds of different, in fact, Z-Wave devices out there that will learn in as long as one of these 3 sections of programming is turned on for Z-Wave automation devices. So now that we're done turning on the Z-Wave feature, as well as enabling the lights, locks, and thermostat features on here, we want to go ahead and hit End, and then Exit, and everything will power down and reboot and save our changes. Once the system is powered back up, if you select the Home Services button now, and go ahead and select Z-Wave, you'll notice everything we've turned on is there. We have switches, thermostats, door locks. You'll also notice that there's a Scenes button as well as the Rules, which is disabled because of what we selected on Section 79. But with the Alarm.com feature, which most of you will be using, you are able to create Scenes and Rules via the website.